I just cutting this top section, cutting out a little bit longer and whittling it in when I get up there. It's a little bit hard to get an exact measurement of the top section putting together. Hopkins plaster have done a good job keeping this cornice nice and thin there and strong. Looks. We cut it, make it a bit longer, that might have come up quite good. I've extended the length of that. Next thing I'll do is pin this up into place and see if we have a bigger one here matches up. Worked out pretty good, made that top bit longer. I've got the join in the middle, light is quite good. I'll try and set these up, check these are going to fit before I make a mix of corner cement. This one, a little bit open, that miter. I might cut another piece just so I can get a bit more length out of that. It's probably best to trace around the ceiling first, I think, and the best way to get the miters. Getting there, still got a lot of work to do making this freehand and the other side also. That ceiling had to be sort of angled up here from the original height of the ceiling, otherwise the miters wouldn't be level for there to be existing, so that's worked out okay. Okay, it's going to be about as good as I'm going to get it. It should come up okay, it's pretty level. That's it at that stage. Okay, I'm going to loosen these screws off a bit so we can get a bit of corner cement up in behind there. Just enough to squeeze it in. I'll do the same over here too. Mixed up some corner cement, just soaking. Come back in a minute. Okay, we're gonna sort of squeeze that in behind there. I've lowered the corners down.
You call it soccer?
No.
Nothing.
I'll tighten these screws back up in a minute. Pull it back into shape. Now we've got the corner cement squeezed in there. So it's going to have the screws to hold it up and the corner cement on the cupboard. I'm just relying on the screws. I'll do these back up again. And we've got to fill the centre up also. Okay, we'll squeeze it in where the cornice joins. Just put those dogs there before because they're going to hold the camera as well. Okay, pushing it right up in behind the open mitre. Make it quite strong. Actually, it's a stronger mitre when they're kept tight together, really. It's sort of reinforced from the back. Okay, put that on. You've got to shape that up a bit too. Starting to take up a little bit of the corner cement. Okay, come back a little bit later. Float the ceiling out too. Give it a brush over some water. Shape it up. There's 40 grit tape for this. Helps get a basic shape quickly. Just a little bit of carving here. Takes up. And a big hole up there to fill also. Okay. Fill this big one up. Okay, well, keep shaping it up. Come back a bit later. Okay, so after the first mix, quite well, reasonably shaped up a lot of it, but gotta have to finish it off all up there. Just sharpen it up a bit. Okay, we'll come back a bit later. Okay, just starting the other side of the cupboard now. I'm going to let the corners loosen the screws off, let it drop down. I'm going to push the corner cement right in there and tighten the screws up. A little bit of pre-filling. And that one's coming along okay. It's onto the second mix at the moment. Okay, filled the metal up. I'm going to brush it into shape a bit. And on the top also there. Filling in a big hole up there. Okay, we're just putting the finishing touches to it. Almost there with it now. I'm taking four mixes. Hi, well, hope you enjoyed that. We put up a two-piece cornice, joined it in the middle of the gutter, either side, cut the top of the ceiling away, about 5 to 10 mil, humed it back into existing, and joined it up to the old mitres, and there. And been a bit down the cupboards here, patching up a bit too also. The main bit was the cornice, so hope you enjoy that. Hopkins made the cornice. Did a good job. It was a tight gutter and they couldn't get it all and make it normal way, so they wouldn't have been too hard to get out of the mould. Okay, all the best. Take care. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks. Bye.